Sonali, what exactly happened today?
Well, the idea here is that blockchain can be a key piece here of what is critical financial infrastructure. When you think about SWIFT, you don't think about it day to day, Emily, because it's really underlying the entire global financial system, barring a few regions, as we know. Remember, certain Russian banks were cut off from SWIFT in the wake of the start of the war in Ukraine. But remember, this does connect banks globally. It is essentially a lifeline between the banks in terms of being a messaging system and a way to really kind of track what's going on among different firms across countries around the world, hundreds of countries and thousands of messages routinely. So why does blockchain matter? Because this is something that is involving a fintech company, Symbiont. It is involving Citigroup, which is one of the largest transaction banks in the world, that also is one of the most global banks in the world, Vanguard, Northern Trust. And remember, these are all companies that deal a lot with the safety and security of just the movement of assets around the world. So the testing of blockchain would really be a potential to really upgrade critical infrastructure simply with how messaging and communication works just across financial institutions of so many types across the world.
So how long will this pilot be running? And if it works, could we see a potential big change in the underlying technology here?
Yeah, and listen, remember, the reason I brought up the Russia issue as well is because when they were really cut off and certain institutions were cut off from SWIFT, there was a lot of concern, Emily, about Russia, China really developing their own type of SWIFT or a rival to SWIFT to be able to develop their own critical infrastructure by means of technology and other infrastructure to really start to communicate, to build a new, essentially, financial system. And you do see some traces of that and some acceleration of that this year. So the idea of using blockchain to really strengthen infrastructure among the SWIFT system itself, is there potential? Yeah, absolutely. But you know, when you think about blockchain itself, there is a huge debate in the fintech community, in the banking community. Is blockchain the best technology to really be used to communicate among all of these entities? And is it the safest? Is it the most secure? Because that's what it comes down to at the end. At the end of the day, remember, this is a way to really kind of put the network together, but at the end of the day, the banks and the financial institutions themselves are responsible for the data and the safety and security of that data. So there are some applications that can really be helpful in the future. Clarity, tracking that data in terms of the firms themselves, taking a look and seeing what's possible in terms of anti-money laundering, fraud within their own firms. But again, they have to make that decision, okay. Emily, if blockchain is the best means to do it.